Oh, you look great. Dang, you guys look good. We picked the right color.
Let's do a twirl.
Twirl!
Well, it's really long. Can you open his eyes? You can open.
Dear family and friends, we are gathered together here in the sight of God to join together Cole and Elena in holy matrimony. God has established marriage for our welfare and enjoyment. Marriage is a sacred union between a man and a woman and offers each the opportunity to know and grow in the grace of God together. Our Lord has declared that a man shall leave his parents and unite to become one with his wife. The union of marriage is not an isolated relationship, rather is a covenant expression of community and the joining of two separate families to become one. So with that stated here today, may I ask, who gives this woman to be married?
I do, our grandma.
Cole, you may go get your bread.
Thank you, sir.
Let's pray. Father, thank you for how you have orchestrated this event and this union according to your will and your word. Father, thank you for Cole and Elena. I ask that you would be with them as they share their vows, and I thank you in advance for sustaining them as they live out their vows for as long as they both shall live. Father, would you use them mightily in their marriage to be an example of your love and grace to the world. May their marriage be a living testimony of your gospel, and may their lives be a living sacrifice for your name, your fame, your glory, and for their joy. In Jesus' name, and all God's people said, amen. Before we begin, I want you two to know just how deeply loved that you are. Just take a moment and look around at all the friends and family that came. Cole and Elena, it has been one of the greatest joys of my life to walk with you, to work with you, and to see you grow in your relationship with Jesus, your love for him, and your love for one another. I want to take a moment to encourage you with three words. I have one for each of you and one for the both of you together. Elena, my word for you is the word cultivate. In Ephesians chapter 4, the Apostle Paul exhorts the church to cultivate unity by reminding them to walk in a manner worthy of their calling with all humility, gentleness, patience, and bearing with one another in the eagerness to maintain the unity of the Spirit and the bond of peace. Elena, the truth is you are not the woman that you used to be. Under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, through faithful obedience, with the help of many friends and family members, you have become an amazing godly woman. And now today, a beautiful bride. Elena, I've seen you flourish in so many ways over the years that I've known you. And as you know, none of this just happens overnight. It is carefully cultivated through lots of time, lots of love, lots of laughs, lots of prayer, and lots of care. Elena, I pray that God would continue to use you in the same way in your marriage, to cultivate a home where Christ is honored and cherished above all. And as a result, your marriage will never cease to flourish and to be pleasing to the Lord. Elena, may the Lord bless you and strengthen you and keep you. I'm proud of you and I love you. Cole, you made it. Cole, my word for you is the word pursue. Cole, you've never given up easily. You've never turned aside. You knew what you wanted and ran after it. You pursued Elena and you won her heart, even from thousands of miles away. Cole, I pray that this would be a mark and an anthem of your marriage. I pray that you will continue to pursue Elena in providing for her and creating a home for her to flourish in. I pray that you will continue to pursue Elena in protecting her heart by loving her as the Bible commands you to love sacrificially. And I pray that you will continue to unwaveringly pursue her welfare and joy in the Lord by laying your life down to serve her as Jesus has done for his bride, the church. Continue in these things. Pursue them. Fight for them. And you will see your beloved flourish for as long as you both shall live. Love you, ma'am. Now at this time, Cole and Elena have prepared their personal vows, and they will share them with one another at this time. Cole, you're going first.
I promise to love you all my days. I promise to put myself aside for you. You will always come first in my action and heart. I promise to lead you in Christ to the best of my ability and remain your helper forever. I vow to love you beyond duty. Delight, humor, and love will mark our marriage. I promise that there will be no conditions to my love for you. No matter the season, no matter the trial, no matter the struggle, the joys or the pains, I will always love you and for completely love you, for my soul has found the one it loved. I vow to dedicate myself to you and your good and to nurture our joy with one another. It is here today that I can say with full and complete confidence that I love you and my heart is yours.
As long as I live, I promise to love you every day of your life. As long as I live, I promise you will have someone who has your back and is in your corner every day. I promise to be faithful to you, to stay by your side, and to never leave you. I promise to encourage you towards Christ every day and to remind you of your identity in Him. When I fall short, I promise to ask for forgiveness. Likewise, I promise to extend forgiveness to you. I promise to honor you, respect you, and be for you always. As Jonathan said, do all that is in your heart, do as you wish. Behold, I'm with you heart and soul. I love you.
Elena, with this ring.
Elena, with this ring.
I embrace our covenant together.
I embrace our covenant together.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Elena, take the ring and place it on Cole's left hand and repeat after me. Cole, with this ring, I embrace our covenant together. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. All right then, now is the time that we've all been waiting for.
That I've been waiting for.
Y'all ready? All right, well, here we go. With the power that has been invested in me by God and the state of Arizona, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride.
Stepping on your dress, I'm sorry. Oh!
I'm coming home to your
tent. You want to do a little spin? Oh, big spin. Okay.
I thought we were doing the pizza slice.
We are. I was just saying for the practice part. Here, a lot of fun.
Oh! And now we go this way. Okay.
Okay. Yeah, that's a good one.
Okay.
All right.
Do this without you.
You want to hold on to that really quick?
So ready.
And I'm like, you tease.
Going for an actual kiss.
I love you so much. I didn't even know you were the only husband for my whole life. I cry when I think about how much I love you and how much you love me, because I know you love me unconditionally and you will always be with me. My dreams. And you want to show me that you, because you've just been so faithful and steadfast with us through everything. I'm gonna make myself cry.
When I met you, shortly after we met, when I was 19, I thought to myself, I hope I get to marry that man. I hope I'm the one that gets to love him. You're a treasure to me. I've never met anybody like you. You mean the world to me. Thank you for loving me. Thank you for being so gentle and kind and patient towards me and continuing to pursue me.
Yeah. We made it.
We made it.
I could give you a high five right now.
I love you.
I love you.
A taste in my mouth, girl, you're the only one.